laugh.
On your own up there, but I can see a star. I hope one day my watch works like a VCR. But I can feel you still. Oh, can you tell? And if history repeats, I'll be right here. Cause I'm still under your spell, as far as I can tell. But you never worried about me. When you love your body from your shoulder blades to your rollerblades.
Love your
and I taught you how to beat everything when the moment
came. Leave your problems. Don't go back.
What up, everybody? It's the Well-Spoken Token coming at you again with another episode. I'm here with my brother.
Yeah.
What's going on, my man? How you doing today?
I mean, I'm straight, I guess.
Okay, I'm glad to hear you're good. I'm doing well. I'm actually in such high spirits today that I wanted to go ahead and sit down, and I'm trying to do a bonus pod. I was like, I've got to make a trip home, right? So we're trying to do something different, right? We want to try to make like as many motherfuckers as these as possible. So what we're doing is something different. We're trying to like seek out like a topical podcast, for you guys that has nothing to do with time, so that we can just like, you know, have that ready for the people. Because instead of me, you know, being like lazy or something like that, or missing out on a pod, you know, we hit you motherfuckers with another one, you know, one in the tuck. So with these kind of things, we're like, let me aim a little bit. So I was thinking, what can I hit that we haven't been able to talk about in a while? You know, an opportunity to get that shit out, because the shit we say, oh, we're gonna hit that later, basically. And you know, this is an opportunity to do so. So you know, we always kind of like skirt and dodge around like female names and different shit like that.
Female.
Yeah. You know, oh yeah. Hold on.
Female.
Is that like appropriation
or significant others?
Significant, whatever. Yeah, SOs, significant others,
or prospective SOs, or people who thought we were SOs but we really weren't,
or individuals you had like a great time with and was just wanted to kind of like be with. You know?
Yeah.
Sometimes it's just nice to have a companion.
Yeah,
friends out. And companions. You know,
shout out to companionship.
Shout out to the companions. You know, I love to turn into a bear or a werewolf.
What?
Skyrim is a Skyrim.
Ah, yeah. Skyrim companions.
Yeah, I'll just what the fuck were the niggas? The niggas that transformed into werewolves. They were called the companions.
I don't know. I didn't get the DLC.
Really?
Never.
That's not
DLC.
Even. I think that's main game. That shows me either.
That's not main game.
Vampires
are main game. Vampires are always main game.
What the fuck are the niggas' name when you're walking through
I
the
don't
town?
Know.
The either way.
I don't know. I didn't.
That's
get
a
the
whole
DLC.
Fucking Skyrim thing that I'm.
I don't know.
Like,
I haven't beat Skyrim. Been 13 years.
13 years. You know, that's the first game I ever stole.
Oh yeah?
Yeah, no, straight up.
That's the one you broke your cherry on?
That's the one I was just like, hey, I need to pay like some kind of rent.
Yeah.
And I was like stuck on down on my luck.
So like Skyrim, which is a $19 game right now.
I was working at a local chain. Not a big chain, actually.
Nigga, you're never gonna work for Blockbuster again. Go ahead.
Blockbuster?
Oh,
it is a BB.
Oh, word?
Yeah, it's not Blockbuster. It was
holy
a
holy shit. I don't know.
It is a BB initial, but I'm not gonna incriminate myself.
Yeah,
but
shouldn't.
I was working there, right? And they had.
I'm really trying to.
I'm dead ass. What I basically is setting myself up so I can never work a regular job ever again.
Yeah, for real.
So I went to loss prevention at this said job, and I moved all the cameras on Black Friday.
Yeah, of course.
Now Skyrim had been staring me in my face because it hadn't come out yet, right? I'm in college at the time. So like when you work at a GameStop.
Nigga, bleep this shit out.
I mean,
bleep this shit out and tell me where the fuck
Best
you
Buy.
Working.
I was working at Best Buy.
Ah. What did I say?
You said Blockbuster.
Oh, yeah, I
was
wrong.
Damn,
as fuck.
I'm not that old.
Okay, cool. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, I see where I
I forgot we could bleep this.
Yeah, blue and yellow.
They are both blue and yellow. That's hilarious. Damn, Best Buy.
Yeah.
But no, fucking. So I'm working at Best Buy, and I'm like, all right, bet. All the new games, you get them early, right? There's boxes in that are labeled Call of Duty Modern Warfare 3, fucking Skyrim, goddamn Assassin's Creed Revelations. So all these games are staring us in the face and be like, damn, that'd be cool if you could play them. But you know, if you hook them bitches to the internet, that the first thing that's going to happen is fucking Microsoft or fucking Ubisoft or whoever the fuck owns the game is going to immediately fucking like get you. You're going to get fired and sued probably.
Wow.
You get a fine or some shit like that.
It's just a fine.
And you get fired. Like, you're fired from your funky ass temporary ass.
Is that why you really got fired?
No, that's not it. That's not it.
Because you said that you were stealing time.
No,
and I'm like,
that's the truth.
That don't seem
right. I'm going to get to that. But no, this happened and I never got caught because I was smart about it. So, yeah. Again, these games are staring
at me in
my fucking face.
But you weren't smart about stealing time.
Yeah, well, that was fucked up. All right. I'll get to that in a second. But no. Swear to God, I was like, all right, cool, it's Black Friday. The games are releasing, right? Motherfucker, I had to be there at fucking like 4 a.m., right?
Yeah.
Like, I'd already worked the shift the day before from like fucking 1 p.m. to 12 a.m. And then I was like, I had to drive back to Jacksonville. And then fucking like 4 a.m. drive back there. I was tired. Yeah. I was upset. And I've been sleeping on the couch. And I was like, I'm going to sleep on the couch when I go back from home from my lunch. And right. I was like, I got to pay these niggas back because I was sleeping on Locastro's brother's fucking couch. And I was like, dope. I'm going to get these niggas Skyrim. I'm going to get myself Assassin's Creed Revelations because I beat all the other games. I want to play this one. All right. And then I might even fucking hit them bitches over the head for another one. But then I was like, nah, fuck that. Yeah, I only need to get two.
Greedy.
Yeah, but I didn't want to get greedy. So here's what I did. I went to fucking Loss Prevention. Like that day, like right there, like as shit got winded down, like at fucking like 12 a.m. Like right before, like it was 12 a.m. It was midnight, and I'm like, I'm about to go on my little break, right? Like or, like before 4 a.m. I go in that bitch, and I move all the cameras like out
so, like,
of the video game section.
Like, so like were the cameras like on the wall type shit?
No, nah, so above you. Like they're all on the ceiling.
Y'all should have knew better.
Yeah, they're all on the ceiling and shit. And the thing about it is that when you work in gaming and something like that, technically you have the, like you can work loss prevention for a while. Because nobody wants to work that shit because it's boring. Yeah. Like you just sit
and
around.
Also just like I couldn't work loss prevention because I'd be worried, mad like, that I had to bust a nigga.
Exactly. People be worried like, oh, I have to catch somebody. And then what happens then? Or what if they punch me? I was like, I'm not really afraid.
I don't care if I get punched.
I'm big. I'm black. So yeah. Like, cool.
I'm worried that I would let him go.
Yeah, right? I'm not. Like, I'm not at all.
Yeah, man, fuck these niggas.
Nothing ever happens. Yeah. Nobody's fucking stupid. Like, and if you're going to get caught,
niggas
right?
Is definitely stealing shit, bro.
No, here's the deal. You let them go. They tell you this from the get. There's like, hey, don't grab anybody. Don't chase anybody. If you catch them, talk to them. Yeah. If they keep going, leave them alone.
Right.
It's a no chase policy.
Oh, shit.
It's stupid. If you want to be a hero and get shot or hurt,
Over a
fucking TV or a copy of Skyrim, be my guest because that's silly. It's your job is not. I literally got hired through a temp service. All right, thanks. Thanks for your $9.
That's how you got hired. At fucking
yes, it was like well, like
I thought you put in the application. And
I got the interview through a temp service, then I went and talked to him. I was like, okay, well, it'd be temporary work. I did the interview. It was a group interview. Mm-hmm. I nailed the group interview because group interviews are my shit.
Yeah.
It's just easy.
I just got to be better than these.
You just got to pick out the niggas that you got to be better than. It's like, okay, you only have to be at this bar.
He not getting the job. He not getting the job. Yeah. He not getting the job.
Okay, that's me.
Like, yeah, right. So exactly. They all not getting the job. He's probably the best worker in this bitch. Yeah, I got that.
That's easy. So I wanted gaming. I shot for gaming. That's all I talked about. And they hired me. Like,
yeah.
The nigga that used to, you know, fucking scam GameStop out of DLCs. That was me.
Hey, all of us.
Yeah, for real.
Time was different when you sold it on a fucking card.
It's true. So I was fucking in loss prevention before I like my big shift later on. So I moved all the cameras out of the fucking gaming, right? Mm-hmm. If they don't see you on the cameras, then they can't prove shit, right?
Yeah,
and nobody fucking touches those cameras unless somebody says something, right?
Right.
So here's the deal. I moved all the cameras out the way. I went, I got the games, right? I'm farming. Now, I've moved out of loss prevention. I'm in gaming. Farming is where you fucking go through and you alphabetize all the goddamn games, right?
That sucks.
From where little kids have fucked them off. It's like, oh, I love Sonic the Hedgehog. And, ooh, love fucking
I think Sonic
Crash
looks,
Bandicoot.
I think Sonic looks great next to Archie, the arch-villain.
Exactly. So now you got to fucking rearrange all the goddamn games. And so it's mindless, tedious fucking work. You know, if you sneak headphones, you can have a good time, right? So I'm fucking farming. obviously somebody's gonna fucking move the things. Right. There's no way that there's.
It don't matter how much I work.
I'm not concerned with the pristine condition of these games.
Right.
So I pop these motherfuckers out the cases. I get the map and the game sleeves, and I slip the case. I slip the CDs into the fucking
right
jacket.
So whoever come and, by, get a nice case.
Nah, here's the deal. I slip those into my pants.
Word.
Just right there at the waistband. And I'm like, okay, cool. The CDs will hold, right? And then I'm like, all right. And you have to tuck your shirt in. So the shit was bunched anyway.
Yeah.
So I'm like, all right, cool. So the shit slipped in there. Here I am talking about stealing again, by the way.
Yeah, no, it's all good.
But I had to close. So yeah, I got the shit bunched up. And I'm like, all right, cool. All I have to do is get out of here with these motherfucking CDs, right? And then I report the cases as stolen. I was like, oh my God. So while I'm farming, I'm like, immediately do all this shit because I know there's no cameras on me and there's nobody around because nobody wants to farm. So I'm just there by myself. So I slid the shit in my pants. I got these fucking cases. I go to loss prevention. I'm like, yo, somebody got us for these fucking games, man. Somebody got us for these games. They took the cases out and everything. That's fucking crazy.
I started pointing fingers at everybody.
I found these behind there. Now it's Black Friday.
Yeah.
Everybody's in here. Yeah. Everything's going crazy. Nobody gives a shit about what's happening in between these motherfucking like shelves. So they're like, well, let's check the cameras. So they check these motherfucking cameras. Guess what? Perfect. Oh, damn. There's no cameras in gaming. But that's because I had moved them bitches to appliances like washing machines, TVs, places where you would move the cameras on Black Friday.
So you really did some smart shit.
I'd been plotting on these niggas for like 3 months.
On Skyrim.
On accident. Because I was just like, damn, this would be crazy. Man, if I wanted to steal from this place, it would really be easy.
That's my favorite move. That's my favorite feeling. When I know I can bop this job over the head.
You're working and you're casing a joint on accident and you're just like, damn. And then you just fucking commit the perfect crime. So yeah, I got off like at 12 a.m. I dip over there. I'm like, Merry Christmas, y'all. And so, like,
I'm sure they were happy.
They were fucking ecstatic.
LeCastro to this day still posts about Skyrim.
Yeah, damn. Yeah. And that's literally the first time he ever played the game.
Good job, bro.
Yeah, that shit like open.
You had a Robin Hood Christmas.
Yeah, it was amazing. I got to sleep on that couch as much as I wanted to, anytime
over
I wanted
to. Over a $20 game.
Yeah, it was nothing.
The game was old at that point.
No, it wasn't old, but it
was like, no literally it came out dropped. Like 2011, bro.
Yeah, I was at Best Buy. That was when I was in college.
My math is fucked up.
Nah, it was dead ass right there. It was
opening.
Opening weekend.
I was still in high school.
Shit was popping off. I was like, nah. So I turned that shit in. And like that was the time I fucking robbed fucking Best Buy for Christmas.
And that, guys, is how I robbed GameStop for Christmas.
Yeah. No.
It's a beautiful story.
It was one of the times that I really put myself out there and I just decided, yeah, I was gonna get it done. But I actually got fired from that fucking job because I was stealing time. Yeah. And that shit happened because
I was stealing merchandise the whole time, stupid bitch.
And it was not even like I was stealing time. I fucking went home early one day.
Yeah.
Because I was talking to one of the fucking dudes that had been working there forever, right? And he was like, yeah, you're definitely a shoo-in. You had a mystery shopper and you had like great grades and shit like that. The only thing he didn't do was touch the product. You know, you got to touch the product, put it in the customer's hands.
I
got
to put my grubby ass hands.
Great. thinking now to Corona season, you don't put your hands on shit like that.
Different times.
But dead ass. So like I fucking put that shit up. I fucking talked to the higher up dude, right? And the nigga's like, yo, go home, nigga. You've been here all fucking day. If you want to go home, fucking go home. What they going to do? Just clock out. Yeah. Come back early the next day.
Yeah.
So I'm like, fuck it. Cool. You do that all the time, right? Yeah. He's like, cool. Yeah. I was like, all right, cool. So I fucking clock out. I go home. And I'm like, cool. I come in the next day. And he's like, yeah, just mark your time. And I'm like, all right. So I marked the time that I just did the math in my head. And I was like, all right, cool.
As if you worked the full day.
As if I worked the full day the other day.
You were terrible at math.
And then, it was all spot on. I was like, homie, you did the math with me beforehand. So we did the motherfucking math. But it was that goddamn nigga. I was about to give his whole goddamn government. Fuck that nigga. Yeah. Oh my God. The nigga P Rick.
Nah.
Yeah.
I don't know him.
Exactly. Yeah. You know, I ended up working with him again at AT&T later on. And so, yeah, it was crazy to
look
see that.
Look at you. Look at you. And the funniest. Do the right thing and you still and here with me. The
funniest fucking thing is, yeah. is that I still got fired from AT&T for fucking, like.
Stealing time?
No, I got fired for that phone.
You got fired for that bullshit.
Yeah, but I didn't steal that phone.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Later time.
Well, actually, I didn't. It wasn't even that they accused me that they steal that phone, that I stole that phone. They, yeah. they accused they me of selling
to.
That phone.
Nigga, they had to fire you.
Yeah, it was wild.
They had to fire me.
Yeah. That was like a bitch. That was like, sometimes you fire yourself a lot. And so actually, I you know, I'll tell you what. I think I fired. Have you ever fired yourself out of a relationship?
Have I ever fired myself out of a relationship? Yes.
I would guarantee that I've
been. You know how I fired myself through out of a relationship?
How's that?
Through honesty.
I told the fucking truth.
Yeah. I was honest with the wrong person.
That shit.
For the wrong reason.
That's the wildest thing. People's like, don't fucking lie, right?
Yeah.
But damn, the truth hurts.
Yeah.
And damn, didn't my brain teach me to avoid pain?
Yeah.
So now all my pheromones, hormones, mental genes is kicking in. My hereditary fucking, what's that shit? Hereditary memory where animals know how to fly south.
Evolution.
Niggas know how to lie.
I don't know. Yeah, you're right. Oh, fuck that. The truth gonna get me jammed up.
Jammed the fuck up. So let me tell a beautiful lie.
Yeah, right.
What a fucking Adam.
You build this beautiful palace of words.
Palace of words that you love. But I guess I can't say that I've lied my entire way out because you just admitted to telling the fucking truth all the fucking time.
Yeah.
Wishing that you had lied.
Yeah. I mean, well, so the truth will only hurt you for real if you built a bed of lies beforehand.
You know?
And then what you end up getting is killed over disappointment.
Oh, well, that's wild. Yeah. It's like, holy shit, you lied to me.
Yeah, right.
Yeah.
It's not even just that, but it's just like, damn, this house you built is false. It's like, no, house. Walls work. Walls work. Foundation good.
Everything's great.
This bitch a hole.
It's like there might be like a broken, like the drawer might be a little stuck.
What you don't
like,
know is the cornerstone is actually made out of paper mache.
If it rains real hard one day.
Yeah, the cornerstone will be fucked
shit
up.
Shit might crumble.
Yeah.
But now I fired myself out of a relationship before. Like the beginning forms of my relationship with all right, last time we tried these fucking initial shit, that shit didn't work. So I'm going to just call these motherfuckers by their, you know, and notice I didn't say bitches, y'all.
Yeah.
I said,
progress.
So y'all get motherfuckers like dudes do. So notice I didn't call these motherfuckers. I'm going to call these motherfuckers by their astrology names. That's what the fuck I'm going to call.
Go for
So when I was with Taurus the first time.
Yeah, for sure.
The very first time before
in 06.
Jesus, was it that long?
Yeah,
from like the time that I was like 13 to the time that I was like 15.
I'm
16.
Surprised you count that shit.
Yeah, I think about that. Like, because the thing was that I didn't realize it was a relationship, but it was a whole ass relationship. It was like a whole budding time frame of like,
foundation.
This is the foundation. This is us like really developing like feelings for each other and shit like that.
Yeah.
So I'm young as fuck. Little. Shit is kind of like a big fucking deal. And, like, dead ass, like, I don't even remember what the fuck made me shut down emotionally from the ages of, like, 13 to, like, 14. I don't know.
Probably a divorce.
Or
a remarriage.
Remarriage was likely what it was. But there was just some shit that was going on in my brain that I was just like, I can't speak. So we went, like, a whole fucking, like, time frame without speaking. And then apparently she had a thing. And then it was just like, she wanted to talk. Got back to school, like, sophomore year, right? Like, I was, like, going on 16, and suddenly, it was just like, yo, I can't talk. I don't know how to speak. Like, I'm just here to listen.
And I eat ass.
I don't know what it was. Like, we'd be on the phone, and this was before, like, you could really just be zoned out on Instagram or fucking Facebook or shit. I wasn't digging through fucking MySpace. I was just zoned the fuck out. I wasn't present.
I wasn't even playing fucking Snake.
No.
I was just fucking bullshitting on my phone. You weren't playing on the phone. You were probably doing something else.
No, I was literally just like zoned out listening to her. Now I was paying attention to everything that she said.
Probably beating your dick.
Maybe.
I'm kidding.
Like, no.
I'm kidding.
Sometimes. But basically, like when I shut down emotionally, it just got worse and worse. Eventually, it was just like, yo, the rift was driven.
Yeah.
We fucking quit talking around.
Put the wedge in there.
It was just like, what the fuck were we supposed to do? So we fucking broke the shit up. And it wasn't even like we were really dating. It was just like, holy shit, we don't talk to each other. We don't talk like that, right?
Yeah.
And I was just like, God damn. I really did just like fucking click my way out of Adam Sandler'd my way through that whole fucking little time frame. And I was only
what do you
like
mean by that,
15. Like click.
Yeah, I get. I know.
You know how you like fast forward. Like he was like,
so on, like you auto, felt like you mentally.
I was on autopilot. I checked all the way the fuck out.
Yeah.
Like I was dealing with, like, fucking. I was in theater and shit, and I was trying to act and shit, and like I was very wrapped up in the idea of like what that meant and the hierarchy of that shit, and I didn't feel like I really accomplished or did what the fuck I was supposed to do. Ninth grade.
Yeah.
Like I really stepped into that situation. Didn't. Yeah, I stepped in that situation off of a high of like eighth grade where it was just like, oh shit, you know, we did pretty good.
Eighth grade is fucked up because you get to feel what it kind of feels like to be like an older person.
Yeah.
But like the people that you're older than are not that much younger than you.
Well, when they separate it like that, when you have like a separate school for seventh and like eighth grade, right? So like the hierarchy's weird because you have like just one school, there's two grades. Obviously, the motherfuckers like that are older, they feel like seniors because they're leaving.
Yeah.
Like a whole school.
Right.
Like and you most
have this,
places,
you have this fake feeling of like progress.
Yeah. That's why like if you read shit like Jerry Spinelli's Space Station 7th Grade or Space Station. Like, yeah, 7th grade.
Yeah.
Like, the experience for a 7th grader is the experience for, like, 9th grader for us. Like,
yeah, I never read it.
You didn't read that book?
Yeah, I was never that nigga.
Jerry Spinelli, I really fucked with that whole, like, fucking, it was, like, Jew white kid stuff.
Yeah.
But it was still, like, really interesting to go through a motherfucker's head, like, especially through puberty and, like, fucking talking about girls and fucking dealing
with stepdads. Yeah, no, as a fucking 14-year-old, not even 14, like, as an 11-year-old boy, that shit sounds appealing.
Yeah, I was like, oh, shit. My mom and dad are fucking separating.
Yeah,
this
right.
book speaks to me.
Wow, oh, my God. This shit, this was written for me.
Yeah. But nah.
And every other 7th grader.
Everybody else in the world really likes this book. That's why it won an award, because a bunch of you little motherfuckers
were
reading
it. I'd be forgetting that it won an award.
Yeah, man.
Jason Nelly got a lot of, like, got a lot of...
lot of love out of that shit. Yeah. But so when I checked out emotionally, like right when I got to fucking ninth grade, sophomore fucking year,
yeah.
Right? I came back and I was like, okay, cool. And I was focused in, but I was also like completely leaving that relationship behind because I was like, oh shit, I fired myself from that fucking job. I'm gonna just try to like step it up. So I tried to reinvigorate myself, reinvigorate my image. I started like trying to come up with catchphrases and shit. I was really trying to step.
Yeah, he was a young lame.
Yeah, I was really trying to step my foot in the fucking game. I was like, there's got to be a way to fucking up my status in this shit. I can't walk around like this any fucking more. Because like I said, ninth grade, I was trash in most of my plays, right?
Yeah.
Like.
As we all were.
Yeah, no. They trusted me with some responsibility, and I like continuously dropped the ball.
I mean, as a 14-year-old boy, that's what 14-year-old
boys. Yeah, but I was just like, that shit was like, damn. Like there was
my God, I can't believe I
really there was other 14-year-old boys that were like also fucking doing what the fuck I was doing.
Who?
Actually, wow. Nobody, because like I realized that they hit me with the no Jason. I got to play Jason in fucking Rabbit Hole, right? And that's like a minor part. And
okay.
I was like, okay, cool. And I felt like I was trashing that. I just didn't understand the fucking. Like,
nigga, you weren't fucking. We did Hamlet in ninth grade.
No, we did Hamlet.
I did Hamlet in ninth grade, and I got a major role, and I should not have gotten it, nigga. The fact that you made me like the oldest nigga, canonically the oldest nigga in the fucking shit, right?
Yeah.
And I'm supposed to be fucking this authority figure or whatever the fuck, and my nuts haven't dropped.
There are niggas
and
on
I'm
stage
reading
that are like,
I'm reading Shakespearean language, but I don't entirely understand Shakespearean language.
At least you didn't fucking like get on stage and scream your head off. For an entire monologue.
I did. What the fuck are you talking about?
Yeah, oh, wait, yeah, you did.
I did. I did.
Just, like, look at those black kids
when
screaming
King,
on stage.
When King Claudius was writing the letter to Autumn. No, not even that. When King Claudius realized that he was probably about to fucking get offed. When that nigga realized he was about
to die. Oh, damn. Wait a minute.
In Hamlet.
Hamlet is coming.
Yo, Hamlet really with the shit. Hamlet's
hey,
probably going to fucking.
Hamlet's with the glizzy.
Hamlet
going to
fucking knock me over my head.
With the spizzy,
Yeah, right. And I just didn't realize, like, I knew the feeling that wanted to get conveyed.
What was that
I
nigga's
didn't...
name? Was it Laertes that fought Hamlet to the death at the
yeah,
end?
Yeah, it was Laertes.
Yeah, fucking Locastro.
Yeah.
That nigga just, it looked like he never dropped the ball.
Yeah.
Except for, like,
it never looked like he dropped the ball. That nigga was good.
Yeah.
That nigga was good.
Fantastic. Actually, he was performing tonight.
Oh, yeah?
I didn't get a chance to miss it. This actually dates it, but either way. Actually, he performs all the time. That nigga can perform anytime.
Like, literally, like, when I was supposed to, like, do that fucking monologue and, like, whatever. Like, if you watch it, there's a video out there.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? But fucking, if you watch it, you could just see, like, the face of a 14-year-old who is not 100% sure about what he's saying, but he knows he's supposed to be saying some shit.
Yo, so every time I look at video and shit like that, I'm just like, wow. Yeah. Damn. I really did just, like, hey, I know these lines, and I am going to do all these blocking. And I am going to say these words
at the time I'm supposed to say them.
At the time and as loud and as I'm supposed to say.
And I'm gonna do that shit in iambic pentameter. God damn, fuck niggas.
But Jesus Christ, was it bad?
Yeah, it was really bad.
And the funny thing was is that I say all this shit, right? We talk about Hamlet to put me in the headspace of the very next relationship.
Yeah.
Like, I had just kind of like started dropping like the Taurus, right? Uh-huh. Dropping off the Taurus at the lot.
Mm-hmm.
That's a terrible phrasing.
That is terrible phrasing.
I mean, I was just thinking about Taurus as a car.
That is. Oh, yeah, like the Ford. Yeah.
But, yeah. So, like, I had met this Sagittarius, right?
Who the fuck is a Sagittarius?
Capricorn?
Okay, hold on one second. Let me hold on one second.
Hold on.
I gotta hit pause real quick.